Hey everyone, it's Justin again, your detective guide. Because in this unit, you'll be stepping into the shoes of an algebra detective as we uncover the mysteries of algebraic expressions. Just like how every great detective needs to understand the language of puzzles and clues, we need to learn the language of algebra. And that all starts with algebraic expressions. Which is why, in this lesson, we'll be investigating the different parts of algebraic expressions and working through four example problems together. Let's get into it! Algebraic expressions. What are they? Well, if we think of the language of algebra, algebraic expressions are kind of like words or phrases that work together to create a specific meaning. Here, let's look at a few examples of algebraic expressions. Pause the video here to examine. What do you see? What similarities do you notice among them? What do the examples make you think and wonder about algebraic expressions? It looks like algebraic expressions have a few different things going on. There are some numbers here, but there are also letters here. And we can't forget about the operations. Algebraic expressions have different parts that all play a role in creating the overall meaning. Let's take a closer look at each part. We use letters a lot in algebra to represent unknown numbers. This type of letter in math is called a variable. To create a variable, we can use any letter we want because it's just a symbol that represents an unknown number. Think of it like a mystery box that could contain any number. We just don't know what it is yet. So let's pick a variable to start building our algebraic expression. I'll use J for Justin. Numbers play two roles in algebraic expressions. You can have a number attached to a variable, like 6 is here, or a number that's by itself without a variable. Like 2 is here. Let's take a look at numbers when they are attached to variables first. By putting a number in front of J, what I'm really showing is 6 times J. This makes 6 the coefficient of J. Think of this as having an imaginary multiplication between these two. But in math, we like things to be short and concise, so we don't have to write the multiplication sign. Instead, by putting a coefficient in front of a variable, we are showing that these two are glued together by multiplication. A coefficient is important because it's a number that is used to multiply a variable. Coefficients tell us how many of a variable we have in the expression. In this case, we have 6 times j, or 6 j's. A number can also appear on its own without any variables, like this 2 that is being added to our expression. This number is called a constant. Constants are important because they show a fixed value that doesn't change in the expression, hence its name, constant. If we look at our algebraic expression of 6j plus 2, we have two terms here, 6j and 2. A term is a part of an expression formed by a constant, a variable, or a variable with a coefficient. There could be more than one variable too, but don't worry about that for now. Remember how we said the multiplication between 6 and j acts like a glue? Well, if we had division, like j divided by 6, or j over 6, as we usually say, then the division would also work as glue holding j and 6 together as a term. So while multiplication and division glue parts together to create a term, addition and subtraction separate terms. In this case, the addition separates our algebraic expression into two distinct terms. So operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division are important because they tell us about the relationships between different parts of the algebraic expression. Are they stuck together? Or are they being split apart? Before we get into our example problems, I want to give you a little more information about this situation where we have division and what are called fractional coefficients. Pause the video now and see what additional info Mia has for you in your PDF on this topic. Hey, remember the examples of algebraic expressions I showed you at the start of this video? Well, let's have a look at them now and see if we can algebraically define their different parts. Now, we know that variables, coefficients, constants, terms, and operations are all parts of algebraic expressions. Can you use this new vocabulary to label the parts of the given algebraic expression negative 2b plus 1? Pause the video here and give this a try in your guided notes. Okay, let's see how you did, starting with the variable. Do we have any variables in this algebraic expression? We sure do. We have the variable b. Now, let's take a look over here at this negative 2. It's a number that is being multiplied by a variable showing us how many b's we have. What word describes the number in front of a variable? That's right, coefficient. Negative 2 is the coefficient of b. How about this 1 over here? It's a number on its own with no variable. What word describes this number? Yep, constant. 1 is called a constant in this algebraic expression. In negative 2b plus 1, what word would describe the plus here? Operation, exactly right. Huh, we're left with the word terms, and there's not space to label the terms on the expression, but how many terms does this expression have, and what are they? Well, remember, addition and subtraction are the operations that separate different terms. So here, our addition symbol breaks this expression into two terms. Negative 2b and 1. Great work! Let's take a look at another example. For this example problem, use your new algebraic vocabulary to determine the parts of the given algebraic expression a plus 4. Go ahead and pause the video now to complete this in your guided notes. Let's check our work starting from the top. What is the variable in this expression? The variable, or the letter that's used to represent an unknown number, is a. How about coefficients? So a coefficient is the number that's being multiplied by our variable. The only thing is that there's no number in front of our variable, a. So what is the coefficient? Well, a coefficient tells us how many of the variable we have, and how many a's do we have here? Just 1. So the coefficient of a is 1. Next up, we have constants. Is there a fixed value that never changes in this expression? There is one constant in this expression, and it's 4. Now, how many terms do we have in the expression a plus 4? We have 2 terms in this expression, a and 4. And lastly, what is the operation that is between a and 4? Addition, exactly. It's also the operation that splits this algebraic expression into 2 terms. Nice work! How about we try one last example? Let's see if we can answer questions about the given algebraic expression 5 plus 7c plus 3y. Pause the video here and see if you can answer these questions in your guided notes. In our previous examples, we only had one variable, but there can definitely be more than one. It just means that there are more missing puzzle pieces. Were you able to list all the variables in this expression? This expression has 2 unknowns, c and y. Since there are two variables, we'll have two coefficients. What did you define as the coefficient for each variable? In this expression, 7 is the coefficient of C, and 3 is the coefficient of Y. That means we have 7 C's and 3 Y's in this expression. There could also be more than one constant in an expression. What constants did you see in the expression? This expression actually only has one constant, and it's 5. As for operations, we have a few going on here. What are the different operations in this expression? In this expression, we have addition here, but we also have our invisible multiplication here, gluing 7 and C together, and here, gluing 3 and Y together. So we have addition between terms and multiplication between coefficients and variables. So now, given what you know about operations, how many terms are there in this expression? Were you able to circle each term in the expression? Well, since we know addition and subtraction are what separate terms, we have 3 terms here. There are 5, 7c, and 3y. Really great work examining the different parts of this algebraic expression. Today, we've solved one mystery in the case of algebraic expressions, and we're able to define and recognize the essential parts of an algebraic expression. We've developed our math language by adding constant, operation, coefficient, variable, and term to our vocabulary. Now that you've completed this lesson's video and guided notes, take a moment to reflect on your understanding and decide if you're ready to move on to the additional practice in your PDF. Learning a new language is not always easy, so be sure to complete that next to make sure you're ready to tackle the online practice game and move on to the next lesson. In the next lesson, we'll take our ever-expanding math vocabulary and work as skilled translators between English and math. We'll expertly decipher codes and transform real-world scenarios into algebraic expressions. See you next time!